Hi friends, sometimes back my friend Asis Sadangi and I wrote a fictional story. Today thought of recording it and putting it in YouTube. The subject of the blog was the S. So let's start. There are a lot of types of living beings on the earth. Plants are there, animals are there, and the most talented creature is the human. Animals rely on eat and live, but human is altogether different. Its mind works in multiple areas. As it is said, the mind of each person is an unique lock, and there are huge number of keys to open that lock. Few minds work for their family, society, job, social service, etc. But there are few minds, some other minds, which always try to find the problems in others' life. If the problem is not there, that criminal mind tries to create the problem and get the sadistic pleasure. Years back, there was a family. The parents and their two sons had a very happy life. The couple had a very good bonding between them and with the kids. Around 10 years passed, the man got a transfer to another city. The whole family shifted there. He had a friend in office whose family used to stay nearby. On his son's birthday, he invited his friend's family to his house. Both the families enjoyed the birthday. And the time passed like anything. One day, just outside the apartment where they used to stay, his wife and his friend were talking. And there, the sadistic minds started ticking in some of the houses in the same apartment. The sadists started creating rumor that his friend and his wife had some relations. This news slowly traveled through the mouth to ear to mouth communication to that man. And he started having doubt on his wife, which led to arguments between them. The bond slowly started getting broken. And the inhuman who created this were enjoying the plot. The sadists were enjoying the plot. One day, when the kids were playing outside and his wife went out to a nearby mall, the man committed suicide. The wife and the two kids were left alone in this world. In the process of criticism started pouring in on the wife. It created her life miserable. She went into a state of depression and died in few years. Then the two kids were brought up by the maternal uncle. Like this, time passed. The two sons became young and started doing job. The uncle, the maternal uncle, arranged the marriage of their elder son. They told everything about the boy's parents to the girl, and her parents The girl side also understood the situation, that the rumors created the misunderstanding and so the misfortune. The marriage happened and the elder boy and the girl had a happy life. But the sadists are also there to create some problem, as they are also part of the society, right? Good people are there, sadists are there. I mean, as long as human being is there, they are now somewhat organized. Some of them project themselves as reformers of the society, but still sadist. One day, the newly married couple thought of having a visit to the nearby sea beach. The girl was wearing a sari and she didn't want to go to the water. But her husband wanted to enjoy the sea waves and went inside water. He gave his shoes to his wife to hold. When the girl was holding her husband's shoes, then the sadistic mind of some people standing nearby started working. Few took some photos of her. The husband saw this and started confronting with them. But those pseudo reformers blamed him that how dare he told his wife to hold his shoes, and that male dominance, blah blah blah. The wife understood the situation and told her husband to stop. Then she started arguing with the fellows who took the photo in their mobile. But those fellows were constantly blaming the husband. And when this argument was going on, those fellows posted that photo in social media stating, "See the male dominance. How a girl is holding the shoes of her husband." The girl got angry with this and snatched the mobile phone from them and crushed it. Finally, police had to intervene. They understood the whole matter and told the pseudo reformers to delete that social media post. But as we know, whatever posted in social media remains forever and ever. Some rationally thinking fellows understood the scenario, but again, sadists are also there in the virtual world as well, and they started doing their job. So the title of this blog, the S, and here the S means social or sadist. To live in the society, some choose to be social and some are sadist. What to do? Villains will be there, right? And does the story end here? No. There are different group as well. They get the enjoyment by criticizing some other states, some other language. They get pleasure out of that. And finally, what they tell? Hey, this is for fun only, right? But that sadistic mind also works there. That's why they criticize others' native place, their language. Anyhow, we have to live with this. Thank you so much for listening.